massive warning. These are the types of commands that can wipe out your data, crash your system, or lock you out for good. So be careful. I'm going to show the 10 most dangerous commands, but I'm not going to run them myself. Of course, I don't want to destroy my system. And if you want to experiment with these commands, use a virtual machine or an isolated system on some way that you're not going to damage or destroy your own data. Super important. But anyway, we're not going to execute these. We're just going to examine these 10 most dangerous Linux commands. So kicking off, here I am at the terminal. And what I have here is rm with the RF flag for the root directory. This is the recursive deletion of the root directory. This one is infamous in Linux because this will delete everything from the root directory, wiping out your entire system. Of course, the R flag makes it recursive, so it deletes the directory's subdirectories, and F flag forces deletion without confirmation. Running this will destroy your entire operating system. It's so dangerous that modern Linux distributions have built-in protection to prevent it from running, but there's still one to know and one to avoid. Next up, we have the fork bomb. This tiny bit of code is actually a recursive shell function that keeps spawning copies of itself, overloading your CPU and memory till your system crashes. It's often used as a prank, but beware, this will make your system grind to a halt, requiring a reboot to stop it. It's a reminder that even short commands can cause major damage. Very dangerous. Next up, we can overwrite our disk with zeros by using this command. Of course, the dd command is known as the disk destroyer for a reason. Here we use it to overwrite the dev /sda, which is your primary disk, with zeros. This command will wipe everything, your files, your OS, and even the bootloader. Running this command will leave your system completely unbootable, so only use dd with extreme caution and a backup. So here we're using the mkfs.ext4 command to format the entire dev SDA drive. This command creates a new file system on your drive, which erases everything on it. It's an incredibly useful command for preparing new drives, but you should always double check that you're formatting the correct device, because mistakes here are unforgiving. So here we are going to overwrite a file with nothing. And using the bracket by itself to overwrite a file with nothing essentially effectively erases the contents. So if you use it with an important file, like the /etc directory with the password, which is a critical system file that stores user account information, if you ran this command on an important file like that, the system config file or anything else, it would make them unusable. Your system would become unusable. So always be cautious with redirection operators. It seems simple and it can be incredibly helpful if you want to overwrite a file with nothing or with whatever you want to overwrite. But if you overwritten or overwrote an important system config file with nothing by using the redirection operator, your system would become unusable. So again, super simple, looks really basic, but this could cause serious damage. Now, you must be familiar with dev null if you use Linux. Everyone knows that dev null is the black hole of Linux. Anything sent here is gone forever. So moving files or directories to dev null will permanently delete them. It's a handy tool for discarding unwanted output, but be careful. Moving an important directory there is a quick way to lose your data. So if you want to move files to nowhere, be sure you don't ever want to see those again. Because when they go into the black hole, they're gone. Now, this is a very simple command, but with chmod and the capital R flag and all zeros on the root directory, we're setting all files in the root directory to have no permissions, no read, no write, no execute for anyone. This command effectively locks you out of the system, including root access. It's a nightmare to fix, so only use chmod on specific files and directories that you understand, and stay away from your root directory with this command at all costs. In a similar vein, we can also change the ownership of the root directory using the chown or chown or chown command, again, capital R flag. And here, we're using it to change the ownership of all files under the root directory to a specific user. This will break system services to rely on specific permissions and ownership settings, potentially preventing your system from booting. So it seems somewhat innocuous, but be cautious when using chown or chown, however you want to pronounce it, and make sure you're targeting the correct files. And do not run this command on your root directory, because this is very dangerous. Seems simple, but it is dangerous. Now, another dangerous command is to execute a script from the web. We can use the wget command to access a script from a malicious site, download it, pipe it directly to sh, and execute it. This is incredibly dangerous because if the script is malicious, it could inject malware, delete files, or open backdoors to your system. So always review scripts from the internet before running them and avoid piping directly to sh or bash if you are going to do this. So again, this looks like a relatively simple command, but this is a very dangerous command because if you don't know what you're executing on your system, who knows what horrors could be awaiting. Now to round things off, let's talk about modifying the system password file. Now, the etc /shadow file stores encrypted passwords for your system, and accidentally adding text to it, as shown here with what seemed like a basic echo command and a redirection with two angle brackets to append to the file. This could corrupt the file and lock all users, including the root user, out of the system. So modifying critical files without a clear purpose can leave your system unusable. So handle the shadow file and similar files with extreme caution. And there you have it. Those are the 10 most dangerous commands in Linux. Obviously, they're born out of basic Linux commands. It's the way that you use those. But knowing what these can do to your system and knowing basically to avoid them or how to use them in the right way, I think some of them can be helpful, but some are probably done, right? Just malicious. You need to know what these are so that when you are executing commands in your system, you're doing it carefully and diligently. But remember, never run these commands without fully understanding the consequences. This is the thing that I must stress. With great power comes great responsibility. Being a super user and a power user at the command line is great, but it also means you have the power to destroy everything, as shown with some of these commands. So thanks for watching. Stay safe if you use these commands. Be careful. Huge disclaimer, do not run these commands on your own system because you could completely brick it. And who wants that? But have fun. Thanks for watching, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.